Hello guys, so you are welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to continue our discussion on pinhole camera. So the last time we had discussed the structure of the pinhole camera and how it operates and the nature of images that it forms. So in this video, what we want to do is continue our discussion from there. First, we look at brightness of images formed in the pinhole camera. So what do they say here? One, the larger the pinhole, the brighter the image. So what it means is that if the size of the pinhole is made big enough, then enough light will enter inside it and the image produced is seen to be bright. Okay. Then the second one says that the closer the object, the brighter the image. So if the object is very close to the pinhole camera, then the image is also bright. Let's look at sharpness. So when we say an image is sharp, what do we exactly mean? We mean the image is distinct or it is clear enough so that you can see. The factor is that the smaller the size of the pinhole, the sharper the image. So contrary to brightness, the image might be as bright as it is, but it might not be sharp. So if you want the image to be sharp, you would want the size of the pinhole to be moderately small. But what that also means is that it takes a longer time for the pinhole camera to collect enough light from the object in order to form the image inside it. So that might count as a disadvantage of the pinhole camera. I didn't particularly include it here, but as I mentioned, one of the disadvantages of the pinhole camera is that it takes a longer time for it to form image because of the size of the pinhole. Then the second thing is that you have to almost all the time cover the entire pinhole box with a black cloth to prevent a reflection of light from inside the pinhole. And it cannot also take photographs of moving objects, that is, it cannot take videos, also a disadvantage. Then perhaps we should add that the pinhole camera has also got some advantages. That is, one, it is cheap to manufacture. It does not require any focusing and adjustment and so on. So that is by way of that. Okay, so let's go ahead with our discussion. We look at the linear magnification in the pinhole camera. So if you look at this diagram here, you see that we have a U, which is the object distance. We have V, which is our image distance. We have HI, image height, and HO, object height. So with these four parameters, we are able to calculate the magnification given by the formula M equals V divided by U, which is also the same as HI divided by HO. So image distance divided by object distance, or image height divided by object height, will produce magnification. So as a ratio of two similar quantities, the magnification has got no SI in it. So we look at an example, a question in particular. Question one says that in the diagram below, a man of height 1.8 meters stands 6 meters away from a pinhole camera of width 85 centimeters. Calculates I, linear magnification, II, the height of the image to be formed on the screen. So if you look at our diagram, first we've got a man, the height is 1.8 meters, that will serve as our HI. That will serve as, I beg your pardon, as our HO, object height, which is 1.8 meters. Then, if you convert it to centimeters by multiplying by 100, you end up with 180 centimeters. Then The HI is one of the questions we are supposed to answer. U is object distance from the object to the pinhole, 6 meters, which can also be converted to 600 centimeters. Then the image height is 0.85 meters, equivalent to 85 centimeters. Now we calculate our magnification. Says magnification equals to VR of U, which is 85 divided by 600. If you do the computation, you end up with 17 out of 120, which in decimals is 0.1423 decimal places. The image height, which is HI. Now, from our formula, we saw that HI divided by HO equals VR of U. What we have to do is to make HI the subject by multiplying both sides by HO or H naught. When we do that, we end up with the formula HI equals V times HO or H naught divided by U. Then all we have to do is make substitution. V is 85, U is 600, H naught or HO is 180. When we multiply and divide, we end up with 25.5 centimeters, which is equivalent to 0.25 meters. Now, let's look at our second question, which says that where should an object be placed in front of a pinhole camera such that the image is diminished by half of its height if the width of the pinhole camera is 0.2? So, in the previous question, I didn't pay attention to this width here. So, realize that the width of the pinhole camera is same as the image distance. So here, there is also a coded information. It says that the image is diminished by half of its height. So that means basically, we've been given magnification to the half. Okay? Magnification is half. And we are told in the question that the width again is 0.2 meters as before. Then our magnification we know is V out of U. We make U the subject, which is the object distance, where the object should be placed in order to produce this magnification of 0.5. We make U the subject, we have V out of M. Then we divide 0.2 divided by 0.5, and that gives us 0.4 meters. And that is our magnification. By this, I hope I've covered the magnification formula and also how to alter the brightness of the image from in the pinhole camera, and also how to produce a very sharp image. So we end today's video here. Do well to subscribe to my channel. Until next time, goodbye and stay safe.